Manish Mehrotra. Welcome to Jab We Met.
Thank you so
much. So what's cooking?
Lamb chops with a bangan ka bharta.
That's the kind of eclectic combination that's got everyone raving about Indian accent in your food. Tell me, chef, you've recently been voted amongst the best restaurants in the world, amongst the top five in Asia. Every year you become the top chef in India. What, according to you, is it that makes your food and you amongst the toast of the world?
Maybe my combinations, keeping food, Indian food, to its roots, the flavors to its roots, but still giving it a modern touch so that it becomes a global Indian food rather than just the Indian food. And it's not only about curry and naan.
Because Indian food has been pretty global for the longest time. People have known about Indian curries, Indian masalas. But Indian fine dining is what you've really taken to the global stage. Because earlier, fine dining was generally associated with Japanese, Italian or French cuisine.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I just want you to say, today, Indian food can be fine dining. We have so many thousands of years of history gone behind, research gone behind this food. And people say it's bad for your health, or it's just heavy food, it's spicy food, it's oily food. No, it's not. We have food for every palate in the world.
So your food is everything that the typical butter chicken is not.
I love eating butter chicken.
I suspect you have some problem with butter chicken.
No, not at all. I love eating butter chicken and the flavors of butter chicken. But I want to do that same butter chicken flavors in such a way that you can enjoy it in a fine dining setting with a beautiful glass of Riesling.
So how difficult has it been to take Indian fine dining to the world?
It's been 10 years. Not only me, there are n number of chefs who are working on the same goal for getting more respect for, deserved respect for Indian food. The idea is to tell people that there is more to India than just a chicken tikka masala or a naan.
Nice. So what we're hoping on Jab We Met is that we get to see and show our viewers some of your food, get to taste some of it as well, and talk about your journey. Let's start at the very beginning. Tell me, chef, how does a boy born in a 100% vegetarian family in Patna go on to become the most celebrated Indian chef in the world?
Food was always around. It was a vegetarian household, no onion, no garlic. My father never used to eat. But nobody stopped us from exploring it outside our house. And second thing, what I learned, that without too many ingredients, too complicated recipe, food can be tasty. A simple food can be tasty. A simple home food can be tasty. And there are thousands of dishes in people's home which are worthy of being served in a 3 Michelin star restaurant.
So what's the Manish spin?
It's a bangan bharta.
I never liked bangan ka bharta growing up. Mother used to feed me bangan ka bharta. I used to run in the opposite direction.
And the best part is the bangan ka bharta, which is usually made in restaurants, are very, very different from what your mother makes at home. Jo gas ke upar mein usko jala karke bangan ko, the charred flavor of bangan, smoked bangan ka bharta with a smoked papad. People think smoking in India, it's a very new thing for Indians. No, many years, hundreds of years, people are doing all these things. When you go to Bhuvaneshwar in a Puri temple, they serve smoked chaach. So all these things were there, but people really don't know about it. So a little bit of smoked papad. We put garnish it with a little bit of pea flour. These are all locally grown flours.
So unlike a typical Indian restaurant where everything comes out in a bowl, a lot of your emphasis is on
texture,
the layout and presentation.
Presentation,
as well.
Texture. So here you have smooth bangan bharta, slightly chewy lamb chop, and a crispy papad on top. So you can try it.
It's delicious. I love your food. I'm a big fan. And I'm very curious to understand how you go and pick your menu. How is it that you travel find different flavors, different foods, because there's a little bit of different parts of India in your menu.
And street, I take a lot of inspiration from the streets of India, because one of the best foods and one of the real flavors are there in on the streets of India. Inspiration can come from anywhere, whether you go to Chandni Chowk or whether you go to Crawford Market or Sarafa Bazaar in Indore or Calcutta, streets of Calcutta. Inspiration.
So tell me, are you willing to come out with me into the heat, into the dingy by lanes of Chandni Chowk and see where you pick up some of these flavors for?
I would love to.
Chale?
Absolutely.
Are we ready to go towards Chandni Chowk?
Bilkul.
Let's give it a shot. We've come to Old Delhi. We've identified one of the most famous Daulat Ki Chaatwalas here in Purani Delhi. And we'll have a bit of a showdown between ace international celebrity chef Manish Mehrotra and Purani Delhi ka Daulat Ka Chaatwala.
All the inspiration for my dishes comes from all these places, the traditional things.
Gupta ji, welcome to Jab We Met.
दूध का मिक्सचर इसमें बना करके लेकर आया हूँ और इसमें थोड़ी सी टेक्नोलॉजी ऐड करूँगा देखते हैं गुप्ता जी आपने पिस्ता डाला है मैं थोड़ा सा बादाम डाल रहा हूँ आपने गुलाब के फूल लगाए हैं मैंने गुलाब की चिक्की बनाई है और एक आध फूल पत्ती
आप भी दीजिए गुप्ता जी इनको अपनी चाट गुप्ता जी पहले आप बताइए
मिलती जुलती लग रही है
तैयार है ये आपने तैयार की है
इसको कहते हैं दोनों हाथ में लड्डू और दोनों हाथ में दौलत की चाट The authentic flavors of New Delhi and the Indian accent variety of the Daulat Ki Chaat. Unki wali Gupta ji thodi si halki hai.
Jitni sardi badhegi utni zyada
heavy hoti jayegi.
Aap kitne saal se kar rahe hain?
50 saal se zyada.
50 saal se. To Daulat Ki Chaat mein abhi bhi logon ka interest bana hua hai ki dip ho raha hai?
Bana
hua hai.
This is what I really want to do. Like this is to take out from this place and make it world famous so that people outside India can know that there is something like this exists in India.
नहीं बाकियों को भी तो खिलाइए सब पुरानी दिल्ली वेट कर रही है आपकी चाट खाने के लिए.
In 2016 में ये चीज आपकी दौलत की चाट जो है वो न्यूयॉर्क की 10 बेस्ट डिशेस में से एक बोली गई थी. बड़ी खुशी मिलती है कि अपने यहाँ की कोई चीज become so famous and people recognize that there's something like this also happens in India.
The Daulat Ki Chaat is absolutely fabulous. But what we're going to do next is we're going to try and get you to do your fancy blue cheddar naan in Paranthe Wali Gali.
Okay. That's what I'm going
भाई साहब हेलो ये पराठे वाली गली चलेंगे कम So Manish, what are the kind of reactions you pick up when people get to sense and taste the flavors of Old Delhi in London and New York?
They feel really happy because they have never tasted these kind of flavors there. And when you do these type of things which people really don't know about it, they are really surprised. Like Mick Jagger, he came 15 times.
15 times.
Halle Berry came like 1 week, she came 5 times in a week.
Who does Manish Mehrotra think of as his biggest competition?
I don't feel any competition because there is this space is so unexplored and it's so wide that there's space for everyone. And there are so many chefs who are doing such a fantastic job in getting Indian food more respect internationally. So inspiration and all these things come from all different walks of life.
It's amazing how small the Paranthe Wali Gali is and how big it's
how famous
yeah.
it is.
These are the original icons of
absolutely
Indian
old
food.
Delhi.
But do you see your challenge as a person trying to ensure that these flavors, these tastes are presented in a more contemporary setting?
I want to keep traditional and do a little bit of twists and turns here so that people from outside India can easily relate to it.
We've come to a very typical Parantha Wala place. Let's see what he's doing and how you do yours differently. Kya naam hai aapka?
Sardar Singh.
Sardar, ye Manish Mehrotra hai. Ye bahut mashhoor Bharatiya chef hai. Aap kya bana rahe hain is waqt, Sardar?
This time, butter naan, plain naan.
Butter naan, plain naan. Yours is a blue cheese naan. Aap bhi daliye, Sardar, dekhte kiska naan better nikal ke aata hai. खासा बड़ा नान खिलाते हैं आप इतना छोटा सा नान खिला रहे हैं
क्योंकि ब्लू चीज इतने छोटे में ही कंटेन रहती है वरना लीक आउट हो जाती है और इट्स अ अक्वायर्ड टेस्ट
तो किसी ने ये नहीं कहा कभी एक अजीब सा खिला दिया
हां बहुत बार हुआ
सरदार को खिलाओ ना उसको पता चले कि उसके और इसमें फर्क क्या है
टेस्ट करके देखते हैं
कैसा था सरदार
अच्छा
टेस्ट अलग सा
क्या फर्क है आपके नान और इसके नान में
इसके अंदर ये क्या चीज है सर
चीज एक तरह की चीज भरी हुई है हां व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड पीपल यूज्ड टू कम एंड वॉक आउट ऑफ द रेस्टोरेंट या मटर पनीर नहीं है आपके यहां पापड़ नहीं आप देते हैं लच्छा प्याज नहीं देते हैं सो इट वाज स्कैरी You have to not only concentrate on food, but the entire experience of the guest. जो हिंदुस्तानी खातिरदारी है,
it has to be genuine.
I'm a big fan of Amitabh Bachchan, so when he came, that was my moment.
So, chef, tell me, what is your mantra for success? There's so many chefs out there. What is it that it takes to be a Manish Mehrotra?
First thing, you have to not only concentrate on food, but the entire experience of the guest. And ek to khatirdari wali jo Hindustani khatirdari hai.
It has to be genuine.
It has to be genuine. It has to be genuine. And anybody who walks out of that door should be happy person to go out of your restaurant.
Does all this fame add to the pressure? Because if they've heard so much, they've read so much, they come in expecting to be wowed. And if it's in any way underwhelming, then itna paisa diya kuch maza bhi nahi aaya.
That is the biggest fear. Which I always have that people really come with such a big expectation. That is why I always tell people ki award mil raha hai to ek ye pressure hai. It's not another feather in your cap, but it's a stone on your shoulder that ke aur pressure badh jata hai.
Chef, was there ever a moment in your life when the whole operation was just falling apart, where you thought that? You know, this is not going to work. All the dreams you had for yourself, you felt they're going to crash before they take off.
When we started, people used to come and walk out of the restaurant.
Really?
Yeah.
How often would that happen?
It used to happen a lot. And ke bhai aapka menu samajh mein nahi aaya. Ye to pata nahi aapke menu mein you don't have matar paneer nahi aapke yahan ya aapke yahan to papad nahi aap dete hain lachha pyaaz nahi dete hain. So few months were really really like it was scary. And अब तो लगता है कि कुछ नहीं होगा एंड यू हैव टेकन अ रिस्क बट ये हो नहीं पाएगा बट स्लोली स्लोली आई हैव स्टार्टेड गोइंग इनसाइड द रेस्टोरेंट explaining people what really I'm trying to do. And then slowly it moved up. But in the beginning it was...
So what did that adversity teach you?
If you are confident in what you are doing, and it should be correct, like your decision should be correct, like it should work, I think it will work, I would say.
So, chef, in show and tell, what we'd like you to do is reveal your secrets. Are you willing to reveal your secrets to our viewers?
Yeah, absolutely. See, there's one reason why Indian food didn't become that much popular, because people never used to share. So this is my beetroot. So if you see beetroot, there are almost 25 different layers of beetroot.
Okay.
Like a beetroot chop. And this is aloo ka lachha, that potato lachha. With a little bit of goat cheese raita at the base. Little bit of green chutney and the peanut butter.
So does it take you a lot of time to think of your dishes, or does it happen like instantaneously?
Some dishes comes like this. Like in the morning I saw singhara coming in the market, then I saw shakarkandi. So how about the shakarkandi and singhare, a salad kind of a thing you can do with crispy lotus root. So all different, three different types of texture, crunchy, crispy, and soft sweet potato. So there are thousands of things which you can come up with.
The other thing I notice is that in the way that you present your food, that styling seems very international. So the preparation, the ingredients, the flavors may be Indian, but in the way that it ultimately comes out, is your focus really to make it look international?
It should look beautiful also. That is the part was a bit missing. So present the Indian food in slightly modern way. Inspired from Calcutta chop. Peanut butter, beetroot, potato, but in a different, totally different way, with a little bit of goat cheese.
So what's next on the Manish Mehrotra menu?
Like this. This is the way you serve your golgappas in London and New York. It's tiny. A lady will never be afraid of eating golgappa in a fine dining restaurant.
But does the international palate have much interest and appeal in the Indian golgappa?
Absolutely.
How's your golgappa different from the ones you get in Purani?
We really tell them, like, this is the way you can eat it. You can put it here. There's enough water. You can just pour it here. And you can just...
You also have a version of the Indian chaat?
Yeah, this is potato spear chaat. So we do potato spears. These are potato spears which we make. Mm-hmm. A crunchy chaat. Because a lady goes to a chaat wala, bolti hai, bhaiya meri tikki zara karari karna. So we made an entire aloo, like karara. So there's a ragda at the bottom, crispy potato on top, dahi with different flavors. And it goes...
Go on. Wonderful. So how typically is the response of Indians who walk into your restaurant different from the foreigners who come?
See, I started doing this kind of food, started with India. Mm-hmm. And when we were opening a restaurant, people used to say, you are opening Indian restaurant without butter chicken in Delhi. Are you mad? When you started in 2009. But here we are.
All the dishes in your menu, which is your own favorite?
There are many. Doda Barfi Tikal Tart is one of my favorite. We do sweet chili, sweet pickle, pork ribs, meetha achar, pork ribs.
Khilao to sahi.
I will just get it there. This is one of our signature dishes. Meetha achar.
You do it with achar on top.
Achar, meetha achar. This Gujarati chudda achar, which is good.
So is this your innovation, or was pork ribs being made with achar even earlier?
In India, no. But sweet pork ribs or barbecue, Texas barbecue ribs were there. Mm-hmm. So, but we did it with the chudda achar like 10 years back. And with garnish with aam papad. And a little bit of pork rind on top.
Is this one of your best sellers?
This is one of our best sellers in all three Indian accents.
Because it's pork and then there's a very, very Indian kind of aftar.
Now this is, again, a very, very popular thing in our restaurant called Dal Muradabadi with a Parmesan Chur Chur Paratha.
Parmesan Chur Chur Paratha?
We do it with Parmesan mix into it and top it up with a little bit of more Parmesan. This is boiled moong dal with different toppings. Again, a very famous street food in Muradabad, but not done in this way. But earlier, nobody used to serve moong dal in the restaurant because of the moong dal.
You don't come to this schmancy restaurant and expect moong dal.
And the thing is, you won't believe, this is one of a very big seller in New York. And I told you, like, Mick Jagger came almost 15 times in every time
he ate dal Muradabadi.
He ate Mick Jagger's eating dal Muradabadi. And 15 times since New York restaurant opened.
Is there any big celebrity moment you remember where somebody came and said, oh my God, this guy is eating at my restaurant?
Oh, there are many celebrities, but I am from Bihar, so I'm a big fan of Amitabh Bachchan. So when he came, that was my moment. I was very happy when he came and he enjoyed the food.
These are the kulchas.
Yeah, these are stuffed kulchas.
Quite a sensation. I remember the guy at Parante Wali Gali was quite surprised when he had that blue cheese pop in his mouth. So what are the different kind of kulchas you do?
So duck, pumpkin, butter chicken.
There is butter chicken there.
There is, absolutely.
See, there has to be butter chicken in an Indian menu.
I love eating butter chicken. Only thing is, I say, there are other things also in Indian.
It's delicious. As the desserts roll in, I'm curious to know from you, what's the game plan from here on? You've got successful restaurants in London, New York, Delhi. You're catering to biggest businessmen, the biggest names across the world. Where are you going? Where's Indian global cuisine going? And what is this?
This is one of our signature thing. Again, Doda Burfi treacle tart, which I got inspired eating treacle tart in London, Sainsbury. There I tasted it and I tasted the Doda Burfi here. I said it's quite similar caramelly flavor. Why can't we do it with Doda Burfi?
So where is global Indian food going from here?
It's now, it's on a correct path because now the chefs are doing is a real Indian food outside India, which was very, very important, which was not there earlier. 10 years back, nobody knew what is dosa. But now everybody know what dosa is, and this is that India also make one of the best pancakes in the world.
Mm-hmm. What do we have here?
This is aloo chips with ice cream.
Aloo chips as dessert.
These are raspberry aloo chips with homemade ice cream and a little bit of maple masala chutney.
Aloo chips and ice cream.
Because see, we have a classic, again, combination of eating. I'm from Bihar, so wahan pe besan ke sev ke saath mein bundi khate hain. Gujarat mein aap jayenge to fafda ke saath mein jalebi khane ko milegi. Uske baad aap Indore mein jayenge to pohe ke saath mein jalebi khane ko milegi.
How strong are your Bihari roots? Have you ever thought of opening a restaurant in Patna where you come from?
No. My family works in a food business there. My brother runs a bakery and confectionery business in Patna and mithai shops in Patna. But I've never thought of doing something of my own there.
I think smaller Indian cities aren't ready yet?
For my kind of food, it's still a little away. But soon, the way things are moving, soon it will be ready to appreciate.
The two tastes are also very different from each other. The sweeter ice cream.
Sweeter ice cream, slightly savory and sour raspberry. Thing.
Chef Mehrotra, this has been an absolutely brilliant meal. The most delicious episode of Jab Bhi Met we've ever shot. I want some more of that Doda Burfi. Thank you so much.
Thank you so
for your time
much.
And more power to all that you're doing.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.